we were looking into the aspects of rule-based classifying. Okay, so we just took an introduction part of it, and in that introduction part we came across that, you know, the rule-based classifier basically does the same thing of having coming under the thing called classification. And here what is going to happen, we are going to write rules here. How do you think the rules would be? The rules will be based on the very simple fact of if and then. Okay, this is something which you people would have already learned way back in your third semester itself when you studied what is known as conditional statements. Okay, if and then, maybe in DMS. Okay, you studied something called if and then. Okay, now what is the thing that you can see here? The other thing that you can come across here is using these statements. Okay, we write what is known as rules, and we say whatever may be that, figure out these rules. You come under these rules, check for the rules. If your data satisfies any of the rules, under that rule, you are going to classify your data. That is what it clearly says with regard to rule-based classifier. Okay, and we even learned that there are two parts of it. The left-hand side of it will be known as antecedent, which clearly means that, you know, the left-hand side means antecedent means that something that comes before. The right-hand side is known as a consequent or consequence, okay, which clearly means that this is a result of this one. These are two things that we learned yesterday. Today, we are going to learn a little bit deeper into it, and then we are also going to learn how we are going to classify certain data if it is given, provided the rules are already written. Okay, and also there's one more thing that you're going to learn called accuracy and all. Of course, in this case, you're going to learn in terms of how well it is going to work, okay, based on the rules. So those are the things that you're going to learn today. Very important session, okay, for you to get to know rule-based classifier. Okay, all these topics are very important. Keep this in mind. One or other way, you're going to learn it in the next coming futures. Okay, next semester, next coming semester, the future semesters. So let me go into the next part of it. Okay, so what are the things that we have? This is what we got. We are going to classify the records based on the collection of if and then. Okay, first one, how do you write a rule? You can write a rule, you know, in a general form like this, R1, Y, R2, V, Rn up to there. Okay, the condition and why. What is this condition? It is nothing but the conjunctions of attributes. What is the meaning of conjunctions of attributes? I took an example yesterday, right? What is the example? The example I took. If, okay, Messi and Argentina plays well, okay, then they will win the cup. Okay. You know what is the cup I'm talking about, okay? Very recent thing. I hope many of the people would have catched that game, okay? If Messi and Argentina, very important thing that you don't write and like this, you write this, okay? See, this is called as a conjunction. What's the meaning of conjunction? You're joining two statements. Messi and Argentina are coming together, okay? Then the cup will be there, you know, this, or the Argentina will win like that, okay? This is nothing but the consequence that you can think of. And these two, before anything, these two is nothing but your antecedent. Okay, two things, these terminologies, everything you have to keep in mind. See, you have to learn this, you know, into more like as if a story. Okay, flow, with flow. Okay, this is what it is, then it is what it is. Like this, you need to know. Then only it becomes easier. Okay, otherwise you have to break your head to buy at things, which is not a good thing. Right? So let me go into the next part of it. Okay, what is the next part? You can see very clearly what are the things that we have. You have a condition, you have everything right here, and we have even taken one very big data. Okay, probably I'll take it right from here itself. Okay, so we have taken a very big data like this. For this entire big data, we have written what is known as a rules also. Okay, what is the rules we have checked? Okay, just let me look into it. Okay, first and foremost, this is a rule one I have written. R1 ka matlab rule one. Okay, this is the rule one I have written. First thing, what is the attribute I have taken? I have taken the attribute of giving birth. Okay, very clearly you can see this is the attribute I have taken. And what is the attribute? It clearly talks about giving birth. See, okay, that's the first, attribute I have taken. If the give birth directly, if it is giving birth directly, then if it is no, okay, and if they can fly, and for that, if the answer is yes,
then you classify them as verbs. See, everywhere you keep this in mind, the terminology I'm using, classify. I'm going to put that data into some place. That's very important, okay? That's very important that I'm going to put all those things in some place. What is that some place? That some place is nothing but I'm going to classify that data in a place, okay, where I'll be able to. Once again, yeah, always disturbance. Yeah, see this? I'm going to put all this data
in a particular place.
Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Okay. See, I'm going to put all this, you know, data in terms of rules. Now, is this only three rules possible? No. Can you write more than this? Yes. Okay. But why I've written only this? Examples. Okay. See, all this PPT is right from the textbook. Okay. The one which I showed you here also. Same data. And why do you see the same data everywhere? Because it's from the classic standard textbooks that are prescribing. Okay, almost all data is from that itself. Anything extra we'll be taking right from the net and we'll be using it. Okay, because we have standard instructions not to deviate much right from here. So we'll be doing two things. One, we'll be taking our own data and also the textbook data. Okay, now let's look into this. I've written only three rules. There are only three rules here. Now the question is, can I write more than this? Yes, you can write. Can all the, you know, rules can be fit in when it comes R? What is the number of rules that you can fit in? That depends on how well you write the rules. Okay, see, it is more like this. Okay, it's more like checking the box. Okay, ticking the box. Okay, giving birth, no, then it will not work. Okay, then you go to next one. Can fly, yes. Okay, if it is can fly, what do you say? Yes, what is it? You very clearly going to say that they are birds. Very clearly say that this is the first rule, this is the second rule, and you, this is the consequence. Then rule two, okay? If giving birth, no, see, be careful here. If there is something which is, you know, attaching both the place, now you think of something like no, no, okay? See, make sure that you guys are coming in, okay, early. Yeah. See, if there is a data that is, you know, hitting both the things here, giving birth, no. Okay, it is hitting it both the places. But at the second attribute of it, at the second point of it, it will change. Okay, it will become different. What is that, you know, difference that you're going to see here? Can fly, yes. Can live in water, yes. Okay, what do you call it? You can call it as birds. See, there may be other rule also. What is the other rule that you can have? Giving birth is equal to no. Can fly is equal to yes. Living in water is equal to yes. Then you can conclude as one, you know, mammal or any of the animal that is going to come. Now, what is that animal which will be doing all the three? Giving birth directly, no. Can fly, yes. Okay. Will they live in water? Yes. I don't think so there's any animal like that. Either you're talking about a bird or an amphibian in terms of this, here it's fish. Okay. So if there is an animal like that, then it will hit all the, you know, three rules. It will become true and it will be classified under that. Okay. See, how do you, you know, the zoologist people will be able to classify the animal data into different species based on these sort of things only. They'll check each and every criteria or in that case, each and every, okay, unique characteristics of that. You think of humans. Whether they give birth, yes. So it will be hitting this one. Are they, you know, warm-blooded people? Yes. So what they call it? Okay, you call them as mammals. In general term, mammals. If they want even more specific, then you can have even more rules. Giving birth, yes. You know, blood type, warm, yes. Okay, the gestation period, or come across something called gestation period. Okay, what's the meaning of gestation period? The amount of time that a person will be, it's like this, okay, I'll write a rule, very simple rule, right? Okay, so what is the next thing? Giving birth, I'll not write full, okay, because again, time constraint. Giving birth is equal to yes, okay? And, see, I'm going to writing it down towards this side, okay, instead of writing towards this side, because I want screen space, okay, nothing more. You can write towards this side also. giving birth is equal to yes. Okay, fine. Next, what's the next thing? Okay, blood or blood type. Okay, blood type is equal to, you call it as warm. See, be careful with the way I'm writing. This should be in double quotes. Even when you're writing it for the rules, right? It should be in double quotes. Okay, because those are the attributes you're basically checking for. And these are conditions. Okay. What is the next thing that you have? Okay, one more thing I'll write. What is the gestation period? Okay, gestation period is equal to, say, 9 months. Okay, then can you deduce this as, you know, a human? No. I'll say why. Because human, okay, you can't find, okay, you can't find human. So you can have to differentiate you between a human and a cow. You have to write one more rule. What is that one more rule you can write? You can write something like, you know, number of legs is equal to, say, 4. Then based on all these things, what is the rule that really hit it? It will be hitting for a cow or a buffalo. Okay, cow, buffalo, that family. Okay, if the number of legs is equal to 2, then you maybe it will be hitting your human. Okay. See, it should be true for everything. Because why it should be true for everything? I'm using and. Okay, where is and? One more and. What is the thing with regard to and? And will only work if both are true. True and true, then only you have a true. Okay, again, don't make me to, you know, learn all these DMS, AD concepts. Okay, so and true and true, then only it is true. Otherwise, it will be false. Okay, even one of it is false. This will be false. Okay, and this why it's called conjunction, because of the and thing only. If it is, if it have been or, you would have called it as disjunction. See how things that you have learned way back coming back. Okay, so you can see this, the rules are written like this. Why I'm talking about this? Because there are times where they give you, you know, certain rules. May not happen in video, but other places it will happen. Okay, they are going to give you rules. You have to classify the data based on the rules that is given. Okay, those examples are also there, so you have to learn them. Okay, you have to know how it is working under. It's not just one or two rules that is true, it should be all the rules that should be true. Okay, so you can see very clearly how it's all written, otherwise it will not be true. Okay, see, because we didn't talk about gestation period in the example, because we didn't talk about the number of legs and all, because we only talked about these two, we directly call them as mammals. Of course, it will be mammals. Majority of them will be mammals only, except for, you know, the examples I gave you in the last class. Okay, not last class, a few classes back, where I told you, you know, there are, you know, egg-laying mammals also, like flatipus, an animal called flatipus and all. Okay, and there is ant-laying, anti-layer and all, something. Okay, which basically lay eggs, even though they're mammals, they lay eggs. Okay, like this. Very important to sort of classify data. So let me go back. Yeah, you can see this. What is the rule one? It's written giving birth, no. Can fly is equal to yes. Then you call it as birds. First of all, you can see this. There are only 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 attributes. Okay, and the entire thing. What is the name of it and what is the class they belong to? Okay, what is the class they belong to? You think of any, you know, example like a porcupine. I hope everyone knows porcupine. Okay, it's a mammal only. Okay, now you see this. They are warm-blooded type. All mammals are warm-blooded people. Okay, warm-blooded type. And you can see giving birth directly, yes. Okay, can they fly? No. Can they live in water? No. Okay, then you call them as mammals. Okay, then you call them as very much mammals. Okay, but this is all fine. Okay, everyone can easily understand this. Okay, easily they can figure out this. But there is some, you know, things where you have to be very careful to differentiate between whether it is a fish or an amphibian. Look at this. Okay, clearly says, warm, you know, blood type is cold. Okay, cold. Giving birth, okay. Now you see this, the rules that is hitting it. Okay, giving birth directly? No. Okay, then can they, you know, live in water? Sometimes. Okay, can they fly? No. So what do you call them? You call them as amphibians. Okay, you call them as amphibians. So what is the different types of class you have? You have mammals, you have reptiles, okay, you have fish, you have amphibians. Any other things that you have here? Of course, birds. So there are basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 classes. Okay, mammals, reptiles, fish, amphibians, birds. Now, if there is an animal, okay, I don't think so there is an animal like that, because I see extensively the animal planet, you know, if there is an animal that eats all these things, you know, blood type is, you know, cold-blooded type, whether they give directly to, you know, the bird, no, they lay eggs. Okay, can they fly? Yes, they can fly. Can they live in water? Yes, they can live in water. Okay, which animal is that? No. If there is an animal like that, then a new classification will be done. That's how the zoologist people will be doing it. Okay, see, majority of the animals that are discovered will either be put into any of these sort of categories. You are talking about something like a mammal, okay? Please learn into, you know, the environment part also, okay? It will be really helpful for you. Get to know, you know, what is the new things that are happening around the environment, okay? Especially because, you know, the South India is having this thing called Western Ghats, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So there's a lot of discoveries always being made there. And of course, in the Northeast. So there are two places where, you know, you can always think that majority of the new species can be, you know, comes into picture. One is the Western Ghats. And of course, the next part is with regard to all the Northeastern, you know, hilly regions. Okay, two places. You don't find it in Delhi. You don't find it in, you know, a deserts of Rajasthan. Very, very rare. But you find a hell of a lot of species getting discovered every time in the Western Ghats and the Northeastern mountains. Okay, always get to know. Very, very important. Okay, next. What's the next thing that you can come across? Yeah, what is it talking about? Now, you see, there's a mammal. Okay, in this mammal, it's only your subspecies. Okay, then you think of, you know, insects. In insects only, there are a hell of a lot of subspecies. There will always, then, whether it's a four-legged insect, two-legged insect, like that, multi-legged insect, in that check. Like that, it will be keep on checking like this. And if none of it falls into the picture, think that, you know, there's a box like this. That basically you are trying to classify every data. Check, check, check. Okay. All the four things are coming in, but this is not working. Okay. And none of it is working. So whatever the new species that were discovered right here will be formed as a new subspecies of a very bigger species. Okay. Subspecies of a new bigger species or new bigger type. Okay, examples of biology. I think I told you right at the start of the module 4 that we are going to take a hell of a lot of examples from our, you know, biology or zoological background. Okay, that's what you see here. Classification, rule-based classification. Okay, that's how you can see the examples that have been written here. Okay, now after this, okay, is this the only time? Is it only for zoology? No, you can do it for any other things. See these examples. If the blood type is equal to one that you return, okay? If the taxable income, remember taxable income because we have done many, many times there. Taxable income, okay, less than 50K. Refund, yes. Okay, if the income is less than 50K, we are going to get the refund, okay? Whether that will mean that, you know, you're going to evade it, no. What is the way of talking about this? See, if the tax is, you know, the income is less, they'll get a refund, so they're not going to evade the tax. If the income is more, there's always a good probability that people will ever, you know, start to evade the tax because a lot of money goes into as tax. And in India, you know, okay. See, the statistics clearly say that only 3% of the Indians pay their income taxes. You just think about it. 3% of the people funding the entire country through the income tax. Of course, there are various other tax also, but in talks about income tax, you are only 3% of it. Okay, you always Google it, get to know what is the reason for it. Okay, reason is a very simple thing. The very basic reason is the amount of income that average income that an average Indian will earn is very much either less than that or it is made to look less than that. Okay, there's a difference between the two statements. Okay, now let's think with regard to the next part. Okay, what is the next part that you can think of? We need to figure out, okay, how we are going to do the application part, okay, or how we are going to classify data. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rules that are given here, and we need to classify the two, you know, animals here. One is a hawk. Hawk is a bird. Okay, just like your eagle. Then there's a grizzly bear, which is a bear. Okay, the normal bear, the grizzly bear. Okay, so you need to consider them as certain things based on these rules. So how do you sort of hit it? It's it in a very, so don't see this class, don't see this, you know, what I've written here. You have to go with the flow like this. First thing is, there's a, you know, animal called hawk. What is the hit, you know, what is the rules that it will hit? Worm, you know, blood type is equal to worm. So check, blood type is equal to worm. Where is the rule that says blood type is equal to worm? Here. Okay, then what's the next thing? Gives birth is equal to no. Check whether gives birth is equal to no is there. Okay, what are the places that you have? Gives birth is equal to no. Okay, and is there only place? No, there's one more place here. Gives birth is equal to no. Okay, gives birth is equal to no. Okay, be careful with the way I'm doing it, because this is how you need to keep in mind. Okay, see, may not be that much of an help in data mining, but it really help you in the future. Okay, that, you know, you keep in mind. Next, can they fly? You're saying yes. Okay, can they fly? Yes. Okay, can they fly? Yes. Is there any other thing? No. Then lives in water? No. Okay, fine. Lives in water? No. So can they fly? No. Can they fly? Lives in water? No. There is no rule only like that. Lives in water is equal to no. Check here. Can they, any, is there anything called lives in water is equal to, lives in water? Yes, is there. But no is not there. So it will not hit anyone. Can they fly is equal? No, it's not required. Lives in water sometimes not required. Now, what is the only rule that is satisfying both the, you know, the constraints or both the rules? What is that only thing that is satisfying, you know, satisfying both the antecedents? Okay. You call it as antecedents. Okay. I'm not using the technical term often, because again, it should not be such a way that people will not understand. Okay. So I'm talking about, can, is there a rule that is hitting both the antecedents? Yes. What is that? Rule one. You can check both the rule one. I have, you know, sort of marked it. Gives birth, no. Can fly, yes. You give them as birds. You don't know whether what is hawk and all. Okay. Think that, you know, it's a new thing. It's a new species. You don't know what it is. You call them now as birds. Okay. Hey, they fall under the category of birds. Okay. So this is the first one is over. So let me go back again. Okay. Let me go back again. Again, you need to know how this is classified. Okay. Because if you know that, you can do for any number of data, any amount of data. Okay, next thing, grizzly bear. So you don't know what is grizzly bear and all. Think like that, you don't know what is grizzly bear. They are given, you know, you don't know the name also. You don't know how it looks also. But don't look into the Google and all. It's a normal bear only. Nothing new in that, okay? Hawk is a, you know, bird that looks almost like your eagle. Normal eagle. Okay, very, very, very ferocious bird. The eyesight of a hawk is too good. Okay? So only you have, you know, aeroplanes that are made under a name called hawk. Okay, look into that. Okay, it will be, you know, very useful. Okay, getting to know what are the hawk aeroplanes that you have. Not aeroplanes, aircrafts you call it in general. Okay, now let's look into grizzly bear. Blood type is equal to one. Okay, so let me check for blood type. Is there a blood type here? Yeah, blood type is equal to one. So I'll eat my first antecedent. Next. Gives birth is equal to yes. Okay, let me go for gives birth is equal to yes. So there's only one thing here. So gives birth is equal to yes. Then can they fly is equal to no. Can fly is equal to no. Okay, so there's one more here. See, you have to mark that also. Don't worry about, you know, whether I got the mammals and all. No, you have to mark everything. Can fly is equal to no. Lives in water is equal to no. Okay, so lives in water. That is lives in water, no. So you just check, see, all over. Now you need to put that in a particular class. What is that class? Check which is the one which is satisfying both the rules. Gives birth is equal to yes. One, you know, blood type is equal to one. You call them as mammals. So that will become your mammal. Okay? As simple as that. Like this, you can have any number of attributes. Like this, you can have any number of rules as the rules keeps on increasing. Okay, as the amount of rules keeps on increasing, what is going to happen? You are going to get more precise data. See, you talked about mammals. In that mammals only, I can split it into many, many types. Okay, you know very clearly, humans are a type of mammal. In that humans only, there are many types. Okay, not many types, of course, male and female. Okay, in that males only, you can sort of split it into various types. Okay, I think probably you must be knowing you know, way back in your school level, you would have studied something called as the significance of people staying in different concept, you know, different continents, how they are very much different, okay, from each other. People in Asia, they are from a different descent. Africa, they are different descent, okay. Americas is a different. Europe, again, a different, you know, origin altogether. Okay, it's called race. You know, people call it, you know, that you should not be a racist or racism is bad. Okay, now what is that basically, you know, in very simple terms, what is the meaning of that? That you are not supposed to call anyone by their location, okay, by their place of birth, okay, or by their place of origin. Okay, people from Americas have a different, you know, setup altogether compared to people from Africa or with Asia. Okay, that too, people from India, you know, people from South India, there's a very big theory, right? I mean, there's lot of people who came from the Middle East or the Middle Eastern deserts or from the Southern Europe. Okay, they got settled in the North India. And a lot of people who came right from the, you know, the continents of Africa, they got settled in the South India, and you can see there's, you know, differences between it. Okay, it's called, you know, there's a very big theory called Aryans, Dravidians, all those things under. People who are interested, do, you know, check it out. Okay, you have a lot of time. Okay, you have to learn all these sort of new things. It's not just limited to what is there, what is you're supposed to read only in your curriculum. You can always go through, learn science, okay? Learn lot of science. When I say science, it's not just engineering science. I'm talking about basic science in general, okay? So this is how the applications of this would be, okay? Now, based on this, can I go for the next very important part, okay? I was talking about the accuracy and coverage and accuracy. So what is this basically? Okay, what is this basically? Coverage clearly says it's a fraction of records that satisfy the antecedent. So only the left-hand side. Fraction of records that satisfies only the left-hand side. Okay. And come to the next one. Accuracy. Accuracy of the rule is it's a fraction of records that satisfy both antecedent and also the consequent. Okay. Antecedent and also the consequent of it. Okay. What do you call that? What do you call that? You call it as accuracy. Okay, so you can see very clearly the, I know the ands or the intersection symbol, what you call it as intersection symbol. Coverage is only satisfying the left hand side of it, then divided by the total number of data. Accuracy, it is satisfying both the left hand side and your consequent right hand side divided by the total amount of, you know, left hand side of it. Okay, what is the meaning of that? Very simple. Take this example. What example I'll take? Okay, I'll take the same example which is there here. Okay, see? You can see this one more example also. We'll see that, okay? We'll come back later. Okay, I want more you people to learn this. It's a very important topic, okay? At the end of the day, we should not, you know, sort of deviate entirely, completely right from our video thing. See this, what is the main thing with regard to, you know, coverage and accuracy? Look into, you know, the rule that I'm talking about. Okay, it's a fraction of records that satisfy antecedent. Okay, fine. Count, how do you figure out? Don't worry about this. You just look into this table. Okay, it's the same old table which we've been using for many days. Okay, now I want to look into a rule that clearly talks about if status is equal to single. Okay, I need to look about only that rule. So I'll write it here itself. If status, this is the, you know, if status is equal to single, because that's an attribute. See, then they're going for a, you know, very important thing called, you can see, then you can say it as no. This is what they are saying. What? No, that they are not going to come under a criteria. What criteria? A criteria of whether they're taxable income people or not. Okay. Now, how do you figure out what is, you know, accuracy? Okay, how do you figure out what is coverage? See, this is what it has been written. You can see it is if. And what do you call this? This is then. Even if they write like this also, it comes at love, then. Okay, now you need to think of, I told you very clearly, cover, you know, it only talks about the LHS. what is called, you call it as antecedent. And what is this? When you covering, if I satisfy the antecedent of the rule. So if I'm only talking about that, I'm checking for only status is equal to single. So I need to figure out how many data I have with regard to status is equal to single. How much data I have? Check here. Single. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't worry about anything. 1, 2, 3, 4. Single is equal to 4. Out of how many? Out of, you can see very clearly, coverage is equal to amount of left hand side divided by the total amount of data. Out of how many data? 10. So can I write very clearly that, you know, this one is nothing but equal to 4 out of 10. 4 singles, 4 single attribute divided by the total amount of data is equal to 4 by 10. Or can I call it as 40%, or some people call it 0.4. But generally it is represented in terms of our percentage only, 40%. Okay, so this is which has been written very clearly. The next thing is, you need to see, this is with regard to the first one, very simple. What is that first one? The first one, which is with regard to coverage. Now our accuracy more thing is important. So this is coverage. Now, how do you write accuracy? Okay, accuracy is equal to, you need to satisfy both LHS and RHS divided by your LHS. Okay, so what is that? You can very clearly see LHS. Okay, but you can't take the value from here. Be careful, you can't take the value from here and it's a different value. You can only take with regard to, see this, it should be, you know, what is it? It should be single, okay, and also no. Both should be satisfied, single and no, both should be satisfied. That what is the count should be written very clearly here. Divided by the amount of LHS data. Amount of LHS data, you can very clearly see right from here itself that it is equal to. Okay, you got it right from here itself, that is 4. That 4 only is coming here. But now the numerator I need to check. Okay, see, remember support count. Okay, remember all those things in way back, okay, when you studied model 3, similar to that. Okay, now you go back and check with regard to LHS and RHS, both are satisfying, which is nothing but single and no. See, no is nothing but whether they're taxable income people or not. If you say no, both should be same. Okay, both should be satisfied. So let me go back to that. So what are the places that you have both getting satisfied? Single and no. This is one place. Okay, single and no. This is one place. Single and yes. See, this is not going to come. Single and yes. This is not going to come. So there are only two things that are going to check. First one, the ID of 3 and ID of 3. Sorry, ID of 1 and ID of 3. Only two things are getting satisfied with both the things. Okay, then you can come here very clearly. You can write that there are only two. 2 by 4, 0.5. 0.5, 50%. Is that very clearly written here? Yes. Of course, it's not directly written, but you should be able to sort of understand this. Okay, status is equal to single? No. Okay, based on this rule, for that, you get the coverage is equal to 40, accuracy is equal to 50. They will ask you this question. Okay, they will ask you this question, theory part, and also to figure out what is the coverage and accuracy. You should be able to do it. Okay, don't always go with the theory part. These sort of things now you should be, see, it brings in what is known as, you know, figuring out, okay, how data can be analyzed. So many things that are there to analyze data. Okay. It will be really nice if you got, you know, put in some interest into these sort of things. Okay, so, you know, let me go to the next part of it. Okay, what's the next part? We are again going to take one more example. I wanted to put it here itself, but, you know, it will be too much. Okay, let me take one more example. So what is the example that we have? Okay, how does the rule-based classifier work under? So let me take this one more example. Okay, see this Lumer, or else I'll... It's okay. Little bit, okay, it's not taking. Okay, fine. So let me take this, okay, with regard to lemur. See, lemur is a type of monkey. Okay, it's a type of monkey. I don't know how many of you have seen it. Okay, they are very common and very famous in the Western Ghats, especially the Sahyadris. Okay, people who are from that region, Sahyadri place, I'm talking about people who come under
the districts of the southern districts of Raigad, okay, and here and there places somewhere close by Maharashtra, okay, and even in Goa to some extent. They are called Sahyadri Hills. Okay, once you enter into Western Ghats of Karnataka, you call them as Western Ghats only. Okay, near Maharashtra and Goa, they call as Sahyadri Hills. Very important things. Okay, all those things you get to know. Okay, because when you're traveling, also you need to keep on updating yourself. Okay, getting to know what is this locally called. Okay, what is the local food? See, there are two things. One, you need to read a lot. Okay, or you need to extensively travel. Two things if you do, you become very, very knowledgeable. Okay, now let me go into this. Okay, what is this lemur? Okay, let me again check with regard to rules how it's been formed. Blood type is equal to warm. So where is blood type is equal to warm? Check. Blood type, where is blood type? Blood type is equal to warm. Over. Okay, next. Gives birth is equal to yes. Gives birth is equal to yes. 1 year. Gives birth is equal to yes. No. Can fly is equal to no. Can fly is equal to no. Check. Okay, then is there any other thing here? No. Lives in water? No. So lives in water? No. It's not at all there. So both the things that are getting satisfied is with regard to mammals. Check. Lemur will become a mammal now. Okay. Lemur will easily become a mammal. Now what's the next thing? See, you know the names of turtle, all those things. Now you know. Without seeing, you can say what is it. But what if it's a new species altogether? You don't know the name also. You're not kept a name. Okay, see, there are two things that happens when people sort of look into any of a new species that can, you know, sort of getting discovered. First thing, they will worry about where do you think it should be placed, the species, or the subspecies, where do you think it should be placed? Second thing is the name. Okay, generally the name will be decided based on the location or in many times the person who discovered it. Okay, it's not complete. But you know, people found a particular type of a frog in Western Ghats, and they call it as Western Ghat frog. No. Okay, they will see the species, under what species it is coming, very, very rarely, and last name of it will be either for a location or a person who discovered it. Okay, the many species like that named after people or location. Okay, you always get to know it. Now, let me go back to my example. So lemur, you can see very clearly, it was mammal. Then turtle, cold-blooded, yes. Okay, so blood type is equal to cold. Where is it? There's nothing here. Okay, there's nothing here. You can see very clearly, it's not written here. But it's all there in your original data, what we got. Okay, the turtle. So I'll go back to my original data. First, just look into this. Cold, gives birth is equal to no. Okay, so where is that data? So I'll just go back to my data there. Take out this. So only have multiple screens. Okay, so don't worry. So you have, see this example. The example clearly says turtle is equal to cold. Okay, so the blood type is equal to cold. So let me go back to cold. Where and all I have cold. 1, 2, there are many colds like that. Okay, 1, 2, see. Don't see the name of a place, okay? Don't see the thing here itself and say, why is he doing all those things? The turtle is not there here. I think it's not there, right? Yeah, it's there. Okay, so you can see very clearly, you know, how it is coming to. Build type is equal to cold. Over. Okay, then again you check. The gives birth is equal to no, they are saying. So gives birth, no. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, then you have no once again here. Okay. One, no here. No, it's get not selected. Okay, and here, okay, then you have multiple no's right here. But you can see very clearly that, you know, these things will never come together. Okay, because all the things should be satisfied. Suddenly you see that these two are not going to come. It's a platypus and all and all, not going to come. Because here it is warm-blooded type. Okay, then again, we'll take one more example. Okay, what is that, you know, one more attribute? Is equal to can fly, is equal to no, they are saying. Okay, they're not going to fly. So can fly? No. So no. I'm going to select only those things which are true for everything. Okay, so you can see very clearly this one, this and this. Of course, there are other no also. I'm not going to select it because it's not going to satisfy everything. So I'm not going to select it.
So what's the next thing? What's the next thing? It clearly says lives in water. You can call it as sometimes. So you need to figure out sometimes. Where does sometimes you have? Sometimes is 1 year, sometimes right here, and also right here, and of course right here. Okay. Now you see what is the one that is satisfying everything. One is frog. Okay. Frog. And what's the other one that is getting satisfied? Turtle. Check. Okay. Then what is the other one that is getting satisfied for everything? Salamander. Is there any other thing that is satisfying everything? No. Okay. It is not going to satisfy. So whatever this animal that you got here, turtle, it is basically what? It is basically of class. You can very clearly see all the three are satisfying what is known as amphibians. Okay. See this very clearly. A turtle is coming under reptiles here. Okay. Generally, it will not be like that. Okay. Amphibians. Okay. All those things are either coming under your amphibians or reptiles. Okay. That is what is clearly written here. One second. Yeah. See this? Our rule one. Okay. Where is it? The turtle will trigger both your R4 and R5. What is R4 and R5? R4 and R5 is both your rules. Okay. This is a rule. Again. R4 and R5. What is R4 and R5? Give birth. Okay. Reptiles and your amphibians. Both it is getting hitting. Okay. Both it is coming under reptiles and amphibians. Then if they take one more rule. Okay, to satisfy whether amphibians and reptiles, there will be a certain distinguishing character between a reptile and an amphibian. Okay, if they take that rule, it will be placing under either under an amphibian or a reptile. Generally, we know, you know, turtle is nothing but an amphibian. Okay, they are not. Very simple reason is, see, if they take one more reason also called laying eggs. Both turtle also will lay eggs and also the amphibian. You know, what is that? People who... Because the reptiles, the snakes, everything, they also lay eggs. But if they take one more, probably, then they'll be able to get the differentiation between reptiles and amphibians. So the rule, the turtle will be triggering both your R4 and R5. So what they have done here, instead of going for everything, they have taken only the distinguishing features, which is with regard to gives birth. Okay, where's gives birth? It is there? Yes. Okay, then they say gives birth is equal to no. So I'm going to say gives birth is equal to no. Can fly? No. Okay. Then lives in water. Sometimes you call there. Okay. Like that. It's basically eating everything. And you see the dogfish shark. It is not eating anywhere. Okay. The dogfish shark is not eating anywhere. So what do you put? It doesn't come into any of the things. You have to go for another part and you have to fit that in there. Okay, so this is how you do it using rule-based classification. Okay, rule-based classification. You got to know two terminologies also, because we are going to use those terminologies before, you know, later. Okay, coverage and accuracy. Accuracy is very important terminology. Okay, so very important sort to you know this. How does it work? How does it, you know, apply and all? If you know this, the next session is nothing but we are going to take a few of things, whatever we learned here, and we are going to deduce few things, okay, based on rule-based classifier. If you know this, all other things is nothing but the theoretical part of, there are certain, you know, things that you are going to reduce there. If you do that, it's over. Okay, but a very important topic, that's very important, you know, that you got to keep in mind. Very important topic of how classification can be done, how the rules are getting triggered. Okay, so that if you know, very easy. Okay, the next session, I think tomorrow we'll meet. Tomorrow is what, Wednesday? I don't know whether we have class. If there's any other things, we'll be having a class. Otherwise, we'll see. Okay, so next session we'll meet and we'll be, you know, sort of putting an end to this of rule-based classifier. Okay, then we'll be moving into the next thing, which is with regard to, okay, nearest neighbors and Bayesian classifiers. See the, you know, the flow. You have Decision Tree classification. Okay. You are rule-based classifier. You have nearest neighbor classifier and Bayesian classifier. Of course, you are not going to read everything in detail because you studied classification first. Then all these four topics that are coming through. Okay. Then you read that entire module. Like that, you need to sum up every entire module
based on whatever you have learned. You have to do it for each.